There were so many jobs that two generations ago, our mothers, our grandmothers didn't think they could have. I remember my mom saying, you could either be a teacher or a nurse or a nun. You had three choices? Think of all the talent we wasted. Think of all the inventions we missed out on. Think of how different the world would be if people who had the talents and capabilities felt like they had a place there. I remember someone asked me what I wanted to be when I grew up. I started getting really into science and I started thinking, how great would it be to spend my whole life learning? So I think that that's kind of what inspired me to go into science. I knew that there's this infinite amount of information in the universe and that I would never be done learning it. The best advice I've ever received in all of my interviews is don't let failure deter you. And you can apply that to absolutely anything. I think we get so introspective, we think we're the only people that feel like we've messed up. We're the only few people that feel like we're not good enough. We're the only people that try something and have to pivot. And that's just not true. Everyone has gone through that. And the people who have been successful are just the ones who push through that. I think that media's coverage of science is evolving. Hopefully, we're shining a better light on it. People love to have information that they can tell someone else. Right now, that information is about like who wore what nail color or what athlete did what. And so I think that making science something to gossip about is the best thing you can do. Be like, you'll never believe this insane thing that this squid does in the deep. You'll never believe what this robot can do. Peeling back the layer of like white and metal and sterile, and really science is really messy. You know, it's experimenting, it's failure, it's personal stories. So I think that telling the more human side of STEM will get people more personally invested. That's what I aim to do.